In Premiere Pro, you can create reusable, customizable motion graphics templates by using the Essential Graphics panel. Open the Essential Graphics panel by either navigating to the Graphics workspace or by using the toolbar at the top of your screen to go to Window, Essential Graphics. You can use the Browse tab on that panel to view the motion graphics templates that come with Premiere, which are pre-animated, yet still customizable so you can edit them to match your personal style. You can also hop over to the Adobe Stock section of the Browse panel to see free and premium options that other creators have uploaded for public use and sale. However, even if you use a pre-built template, you'll still be spending most of your design time here in the Edit tab of the Essential Graphics panel, where we're going to be building ours from scratch. The design I'm creating in this walkthrough was developed using the process outlined in our brand identity walkthrough. So if you'd like to create an original design of your own, watch that video to go through the checklist of how to design a branded image. The graphics panel is layer-based, so it behaves similarly to the timeline in the sense that what's on top is shown, and you can reorder assets as such. To create a new layer, click here. You can create a horizontal or vertical text box, which will pull up your text customization tools. You can also create shape layers to use as backgrounds or assets within your template, which will pull up its own set of customization tools. If you're wondering what a control does, hold your cursor over the icons to see the tooltip. I'll create a text layer with my brand title in one of the branded fonts I chose, and I'll fill it using one of the color codes of my palette. Underneath the title, I'll put a subheading that explains a little bit about what I do. Underneath that, I'll put some information about where to find more of my work, as well as where you can reach me. So now all the information is there, but it's still a little bland. I'll create a background in another color from my palette and add some visual assets to create variation within my template. Add a drop shadow to give it some depth. Once I've aligned it, I'll use the pinning feature to connect my assets so when one moves, so do the rest. Once it's all set up, I'll animate it sliding in using the keyframes in the effects control panel. And I'll add some fades too by adjusting opacity. I'll use temporal interpolation to ease the keyframes in and out so they have more of a gradual animation to them. Looks great! Let's export it. File, export, motion graphics template. Rename the file for organization and choose the destination. You can save it to a local drive on your machine, but if you're the kind of creator who edits across multiple machines, I'd recommend saving it to a CC library for easy access. There are some compatibility options here to help you communicate well between all Adobe resources. Add some keywords at the bottom to help with searchability, so you can easily find your custom Mogurt within your libraries. Click OK. Premiere will export a .mogrt, or Mogurt file, to the save destination you selected. Watch our next video to see how to install the Mogurt and use it across all your projects. If you have any further questions, feel free to reach out to us on Twitter @AdobeCare for answers.